following is a DJ Skee presentation.
Skee TV. We're out here backstage, DJ Hero with a real life DJ Hero himself, my man Zetra. What's going on, sir?
Good, man. How are you?
It's great. So let's talk about the whole DJ Hero game. It's kind of like a mashup, a song, you know, where you take two tracks and blend them together. You've been doing this for a minute. You're one of like the OG originators of it, man. Tell us about how the DJ Hero game came apart and your involvement in it.
Well, they reached out to me, and I sort of sniffed around a little bit to see sort of what they were doing, because I really didn't want to sign on if they weren't doing it justice, you know? So I did some investigating, found out Shadow was involved, which actually, once I found that out, I was like, okay, I feel much better about it. If he's involved, I know he has the same sort of threshold that I do for that. So, that was it. I sort of went down there, got the demo, and realized that the other couple people that they had in the game as well, it all sort of solidified. And I realized they were doing the right thing and doing, digging and finding, like, the right people and the right consultants. And that was it. Then I started sort of wrapping my head around it and sort of contributing. You know?
Absolutely. What was your role in terms of actually making the music and stuff in that? And tell us that process.
That was interesting because they gave me a list of stuff that they had cleared. And they were sort of like, here, you know, use whatever, you know, is basically giving me a crate of music and saying, here, this is, you know, take whatever you want. So I grabbed a couple things out of that. I made three things for the game, three songs. But one of them wasn't on the list, and it was just a concept that I had. And I, for lack of a better term, I sort of call it the theme song of the game. But I really, really stretched out and did a lot of work to craft this tune to make it work. And it ended up, at the end of the day, I think it was probably the toughest thing to do, but it ended up coming together, and that's probably the one I'm the most proud of, because it's really a bit more even true to what I do, which is like, you know, taking a couple songs and mixing them together. I've been doing it for years, but to produce something and take sort of the same concept of going, oh, I have this idea for this thing, and grabbing the samples and mushing it together. It's really vague because I can't really tell you what it is, but when you see it, when you hear it, you'll understand. But that's probably some of the best work I've done in a minute, just because it's so abstract.
So how would you describe, for somebody that is trying to, like, how, this was my question when I first heard about it, how do you make a full DJ set into like fun 3-minute games and stuff? How would you describe how you play DJ Hero?
Well, the gameplay is kind of interesting because it's, it's sort of pseudo real DJ. You know, they've taken as much as they can, all the elements that they can put into it. They've done that, and it's actually, I think it's harder to play. It's hard for me as a DJ. It's harder to learn that stuff because you have to relearn that technology, and you relearn, I'm so used to doing it the same way. But I think they've actually done a pretty good job because, you know, I've seen these guys who are play it all the time, the guys who do demo it and have made the game and whatnot, and they're great at it. But I think it's going to take a minute for people to learn it. But it's kind of cool because you got to pay your dues in order to learn anything, whether it's real DJing or DJ Hero DJing.